Doot, 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 doot. Okay, mic's working now. So, for those who missed what I said in the intro, I said it's Tuesday, you know what that means, time for more of the show. And that was about it, you didn't miss anything else. But, kicking off with Amber Arcade versus Rox in the opening match. And Ember herself won off of the current women's tag champs as well, as part of HUD. And as we've seen in the past, Rox will probably murder Amber. So don't forget, Rox herself, also former women's tag champ. And here comes Rox, she creates violence and she also creates pain. She's big and she scares me. I'm still very surprised that she was beaten in such a weird way by Taylor Jones when she was the Limitless Champion back in the day. That was like the worst case of the Reign of Terror ever. Like, even worse than Alexander's international title run. Because at least some of his matches were entertaining, right? But Taylor just squashed everybody, including Rox. It was so weird. Of course I'm talking about this well because it's being defended in the main event of AVW as well, in a death match no less. But we should probably talk about this match, and Amber is going off on Rox right now. Under right over the top rope. Oh, military press lift on the outside. Good lord, from such a huge height as well. That's a nasty landing for Amber. And after her like last couple of really intense ladder matches involving the women's tag titles, I think she could do with fewer high landings. Good trip from Amber. And for pin off that, not a wise decision, especially considering she didn't even get a one. Oh, just a casual yeet. Although Amber looking for a jumping tombstone. I was expecting her to go for the Amber Bomb, but no. Elbow drop. Another pile driver. Not the tombstone, that's just an old pile driver. Tombstone's like the front way. I know the difference. One, two, no. Oh, good neck breaker there from Amber. Pardon me. Good arm wrench there. And now looking for the Amber Bomb? No! Rocks with the counter. And Rocks is gonna grab a weapon. Steel chair in play. And to everyone's shock and horror, she doesn't get a chance to use it. And with a power bomb on the apron? No! More like a sort of lift over the head. Picks up the chair. And somehow is missing with it. How did she miss a target that big who's laying prone? Three times. I would love to know how Amber fucks up that badly. Rocks drop. One, two, no! And Rox is going to get another weapon. Sledgehammer! Oh, right to the gut. Uppercut from Amber. I will admit, I am sick of that weapon reversal thing happening, where Maud rolls out of the way and, like, the weapon just flies into the air. One. Two. And now looking to end it. Super Amber Bomb! Gets it. Two. Three. Amber okayed with the win. It's a pretty good match. Amber with some pretty good momentum going into the title defense at Fire the Gods. Oh, Ibushi's got one of the most underrated power bombs ever. I still love that counter he does to Kazuchika Okada at Wrestle Kingdom. Was it 14 in 2020? When he counters that dropkick into the power bomb, that's so good. Next up, we got the 13 versus Wandero Ortiz. I don't know if this is a tag team breaking up, I hope it's not because I really like the Sun Bitches, but you never know. And here comes the 13. I can't believe this man was almost a Captain of the Crown briefcase holder. Well, I can because he's really good, but still, that's baffling information. And in comes Juan Dero. I still really like that shirt. Anyway, Juan Dero is here to win a match. There we go. Top-notch commentary. That's what you come to these shows for. Here we go. Here come the graps. Good stuff, 13, dropping Wonder on the rope there. And, oh no, not the foot DDT. It's the worst kind of DDT. And bloody overdrive. That's an actual move in Juan Dero's moveset. Why? Juan Dero did get a hammer, but 13 putting pay to that. Takes a hammer for himself. Oh, right to the stomach. Damn! No chill on his tag partner. Big lift up. Oh my god, almost drops him onto the hammer. Lifts 13 up. Oh, powerbomb just dumps 13 right on the concrete floor. Good Buster GTS. Looking for a package. Pile driver. Throws 13 into the Barry Barricade. Jet it to Simon Miller. Why? Here's why. Thirteen rolls back in the ring. Does some solid beating the piss out of Wandera. Wandera gets a chair. Oh, bell clap from behind. And goes for the sledgehammer, even though the chair was closer, but yeah. Oh, to the hand. One, two. Oh, I'm not really sure what happened there. Whoever did, Burton's been dumped to the outside. It looked like he went to grab Quandera for the move, but like, just didn't land it. Knee to the arm. Kendo stick. Oof, right over the head. Goes back inside. That's actually kind of cool. Good mockery. And Wandero. Oh, right on the hammer. One, two, three. I like that finish. That was a really good finish. That was a surprisingly brutal match for something so short. Also, I like it when someone lands a finisher on a weapon. It always looks more devastating. Good win for Wandera Ortiz, though. Next up, we've got Generation Mexicana versus the Highwaymen, in what is essentially a backup number one contenders match. I'll explain the reasoning now. So, next week is obviously the go-home show, and the Razor Classic winners will be crowned. But the winner will also challenge for their respective brand's tag championships, so... You know, it could be the Kingsman from PBW. It could be Anarchy Inc. from AVW. This is essentially a really safe option that should hopefully lead to a really good match. Here they come. I really should have sorted out their trunks. Generation Mexicana with the coolest jackets in EFED history. I'm not kidding. I really like the whole thumbprint thing. It's really cool. Here come the Highwaymen. Michael has held many championships. First ever PBW Triple Crown champion. And Pistol Era has been here for a long time. He hasn't won any belts yet, but, you know. He could. And it's part of the reason why this match has been put together as well. I really do think of everything. I am a booking genius. Oh, one German suplex tags in Michael instantly. Antonio tried to throw him at the ring, Michael back in for that clothesline. Not quite the 585, but still. Pistos back in the ring. Antonio taking it to him though. Lifts him up. Alabama slam! Takes in Solomon Dragon. Nice elbow. Very nice too. Got around suplex. This Lara not taking this lightly. Oh, there is Saul. Good dragon screw there. Pistol in the corner. Good backbreakers there from Saul. He's gonna go to the top rope. Oh, Pistol rolls out the way. Against a hip toss. Flips him over. He's gonna tag him. Michael is still gonna tag him. Antonio. He does not. High kick there from Saul Mondragon. Oh! That was kinda sick. The Dragon Sleeper. Dropkick attempt, both miss. Oh, dropkick, but barely phases Mikey. Goes low though, that one hits him. Was mocking him, hit him with the elbow instead of the lariat. Kamigoye, which is one of Steve's bigger moves as well. You know, I could kind of see that, honestly. Yeah, he's got a little bit of a little bit of Malachi Black to him. Two. He's obviously like much bigger. Like Mikey is much more of a hoss. In comes Pisto. Ah, Pisto. Release, German, my god. On the top. He wants Antonio up on his feet. Just so he can miss that dropkick. Nasty spine buster there. Here comes Saul again. Oh my god, what a cutter from Saul. I like how Saul has spent, like, he's mostly just been mocking Highwayman in a way, because one of Pisto's, like, his finisher is a style of cutter. Hit that ripcord elbow to take the piss out of Mikey's Paymaker Lariat. God damn, that's just really good shit. I love it when people do that. In goes Mikey. Oh! Hits Antonio with a brain buster! Tokes him for the- I love that Santon variant so much. It's basically like a reverse cannonball. You don't know what's gonna happen. With that release suplex, tags in Pistolero again. Has him up. Building the lights. Go look for that brainbuster. That is one of his bigger moves. One. Saul breaks it up. Michael throws Saul out the ring. Just Larry trying to sit and sign you up for something. And... oh my goodness. Although he's... in some ways, he's completely fine. Tagging console and cruiserweight killer. One, two, no. Moving right into the brainbuster. Stretching on the leg there. Missed that kick. Countered the lariat. Broken runner. Swing over neck breaker. I think that was the McGillicutter. Broken runner. Oh! Michael rolled out of the way. Michael getting the hurt put on him. Spinning backbreaker there from Antonio Montoya. Oh! One. It's all bracketed up. It's a lot of nasty shots for his brothers. Michael just beating the crap out of him still. Big lariat. Number one. And a third. Collecting pistol arrow, presumably to finish the job. No! Okay. One. Hey, to the Americans. Lifts him up again. Huge driver. Is that going to kick out? Yes, somehow. Oh, really wrenching on the arm there. Hit this hole. Try and call him up, and with that knee. Gets it! I think he breaks it up. Yeah. Thrown to the outside, is Antonio going to go after him? Kamigoye to Pisto. One, two, no! Head to Jawbreaker. Satellite DDT. And Mikey's gonna look for the ending. 5-8-5. It's all that to break it up though. Belly bomb. Still listen, send you up. Someone on the turnbuckle. Oh, Antonio caught the foot. Desperation pin attempts. Mickey breaks it up, not risking that. Oh, Pisto and Mikey both working hard to prevent that. DDT. Piss him up. Big post line there. And now for the generation driver. Mikey missed breaking up the pin, but Pistol kicked out. CWK. Oh, Pisto let go of the pin early, I think. Shots there. The takedown. Up to the top goes Mikey. Night. What a counter that was. Eight, five. One, two. No, what? You kick out. Oh, I'm going to turn to the outside. Cradle counter, one, two, no. 585. That has to be it. 2, 3. What a match. The Highwayman with the big win. Huge win for the Highwaymen. Next up, we got Ricky Valentine versus Colin Prince. Oh, absolutely. That was an incredible match. And here comes a former world champ. Ricky Valentine has done a lot in this business. A gorgeous one. Glorious. Here comes one of the members of the Fabulous Furious Freaks. Oh! Big old clawing people. Getting booed as a former son bitch.
Oh.
Here we go. Actually, yeah, that there's a pretty big Ace Austin vibe going on with Colin's gear. Which I'm cool with, because I like Ace Austin a lot. I'm so glad he's a member of the Bullet Club now. Like, that's gonna give him so much exposure. Ooh, fake out DDT. Now looking for the Tequila Sunrise. Colin, he's got a plan for Ricky in the corner. What a knee there. Do you know what I would like to see though? Oops, Blue Thunder Bomb. I would like to see Ace Austin appear on AEW at some point, right? Because they've got a working partnership with Impact, and with New Japan, he works for both of them. I want to see the dude pop up on AEW at some point. Like, fucking imagine for the next, like, big Battle Royale thing they do, that he's the Joker. Like, that would work so well. Shoulder breaker. Looking for the final order. One, two, three. Yeah. I guess considering the banger we just had. Yeah. We would like a wee short one, like, here you go, you just had an amazing match, let's just have, just get this one out of the way. Next up, a kind of, but not really, number one contenders match between Vanity and LGBTKO. And if I remember right, unlike the last match, this won't be actual, like, tag team stuff. This will be more Tornado style, I think. So expect chaos. Here come Vanity, Baby and Baby Cash. The only person still not with them is Natalia, but I don't really care to remember in this case, even though she was there later on CWL. But yeah, I'm doing shit, I will do it. Really should have given these two some trons. They're looking to win the belts back and to fight the gods. I love this entrance so much. Here they come. Well, here they are. Kind of want to finish this crate of lilts I've got, because I've only got two cans left. Fuck it. Here we go, very chaotic match to come. I love that Tyler bait Larry so much. Also, I... 1, 2... Mia breaks it up. I will ask, is there an actual difference between a clothesline and a lariat? Because I don't think there is. What a moonsault from Bea Mia. And sunset flip. Well, leg trap style. Baby Cash beating the crap out of Camille. Spanish fly. Pin. Camille breaks it up. Camille's been there each time for Selena. Bad one to Baby Mia. Just one count. Fuck. I accidentally spilled pop all over myself. Thankfully, the mic still works. Hooked you into the suplex there. I'm gonna change really quick. Get over me. I literally left to change my shirt, and I missed the I missed the win. Still LGBTQ, solidifying their momentum going into Defy the Gods. It's main event time. A death match for the Limitless Championship. Lazaro Morgan versus Morgan Knight. Pinfall, sorry. Submission and knockouts only, false count anywhere. I mean, it's a death match, it could end at any point. Here comes the former champion, Lazaro Morgan. I would say she wants a belt back, but I know for a fact that Blitz didn't like it when Lazaro was champion. So if she wins, Blitz is going to be angry. And it's going to be hilarious. So for that reason, I low-key want Lazaro to win. Just because I know it'll anger Blitz. Obviously, you know, my opinion is completely out the window. By the way, it's going to be a good match. And here's your defending champion, fresh off their first defense last week, winning 2-0 against Deanna Crowe. They were across the golden path to one up there in a lot of matches, but I don't think they've ever been in a deathmatch before. I really like Morgan's entrance theme. And he is a challenger. And your champion. This could go anywhere, super crazy in the match, who knows. Morgan has Lazara against the ropes, being up with some solid shots. Handspring, lovely head scissor. Lazara with a jawbreaker. Moonsault. Trying to pile on all the offense she can, I think. Good up go from Morgan. Knee. Heavy knee. Great series of shots there with the spinning back kick. Elbow to the back. Oh! I don't remember what that move's called, but... Sharpshoot? No! Watch your step to hell! Oh, that... okay. That was it, the ref decided, oh, that's it. I mean, Morgan retains, but... They do. The springboard moves usually look really smooth. But yeah, Morgan Knight with the win. It really feels like the only match worth watching was that tag match, but still some pretty good stuff. As always, we'll take the mandatory 5-minute break while I set up the PBW half. This is a pretty solid AVW half, though, so yeah, see you in about 5.